We are from libraries, bingo halls and pubs, train stations, cricket grounds, ice rinks, canals, the chase, the reeking, from family photos, Sunday best, teachers, Irish and English, dancing with friends in sheds. We're from gypsy tart and potato pancakes, homemade plate pasties and cobs, tea and cake and sharing stories from places of learning, friendship and beauty, from the hustle, bustle, noise and smell. All right, Bab, our bish jockey, are you a duck? We're from the water, motorways, engineering, technology, tile making and pottery, music, laughter and harsh winters. We're from negative comments, new towns and fresh starts. We're from trying and failing but having a go. We have risen from the ashes and we have risen with new impetus.
We have arrived. Welcome to Tappin In. Welcome to the magical land of Tappin In, where anything can happen through the magic of tap. I'm Kit. This is Claire. We are your hosts for this time we have together. Someone's looking up at the sky. Ignore that. We don't dwell up there. We're focused here. We are not wearing tap shoes today for safety reasons, so I want you to do something. We're all creative people, so just imagine the sound of tick, 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 tick in your head. Can you do that? Can we do that? Okay, so we're going to show you the dancers that our dancers have been working on for the last few months, and you're going to hear and see some of them on film. Later, in a little while, you're going to see the team from Coventry and Tamworth, who have uniquely mashed up, and they're called Covworth for the, it's a portmanteau term. Can you sign that? I can't even say it, so it's unlikely. But right now, we're going to see the Sixtown Tappers from Stoke-on-Trent, very popular with the crowd. And before that, we are going to see a short film about what tap means to our dancers. Hit it.
Well, when you're doing tap, you forget about everything else. So any problems you've got in your mind, any issues outside, that all goes out the window, and all you concentrate on is the rhythm and the moves and the steps.
I find it incredible. And then when I started tap dancing, I thought something would change my life, and it really has, to be honest. And that's why I've learnt something new this year now, in 2022.
Last year I was at a sort of time in my life where I thought I need to push myself out of my comfort zone a little bit and do more things that I would enjoy that I might not necessarily be the first to volunteer for.
I'm finding it very good at the moment. It makes me feel more healthier, like in myself.
The day I got my shoes was a really exciting day because I was like a kid in a candy store. I play songs to whatever's being tapped and then I can tap it, so I'd be doing anything you can do, I can do better. Anything you can do, I can do too.
I used to go to a school with my friend. Mum couldn't really afford to send five girls to dance school, so I used to go with my friend, and I used to stand outside and she'd move the curtain so I could do the lesson for free. And it's like a dream come true now. I'm actually tap dancing.
At first you're not sure, are you? And you think, gosh, is everybody going to be able to tap? And I'm the one that hasn't for 50 years. Am I going to be able to just do it straight away? But yeah, we would put it in straight away. It's been grateful.
You know, it's never too late to fulfil your dreams, girls and boys.
start with it's difficult, but if then you get into it, it's really easy to rehearse and it's really fun. It makes me feel like I'm an interested person. It's a new skill that I've been learning for a while, and it just makes me feel that I can achieve anything.
Craig,
yes?
do you like the tap?
Yes.
Is it good?
Good.
Good. Do a big thumbs up. Mom?
I love it. Yeah, really enjoying it.
It just feels that you're letting loose in your feet and have fun with it, you know, communicate a bit more. It's really, really exciting. I love it.
And you get to learn about so many different life experiences and feel connection with that as well.
I'm more confident now. I'm going to be performing in front of people that I know, which will be outside of my comfort zone, but you've just got to do it sometimes. You've just got to do it.
I think not only does it make you feel healthier in your physically, I think it helps you, your well-being as well.
Yeah, I feel a lot better when I leave here, you know, a buzz. Mm. You want to carry on doing it all day.
Because our mind's all weak, isn't
yeah,
it?
Isn't it?
I'm sure we're going to learn a lot more, so I'm up for it. I'm committed.
So the six town tappers from Stoke-on-Trent. Respect. Oh my God. Okay, ignore the rain. It's not happening. It is happening. So, you know, use a hood, use an umbrella. Let's go with it. We don't go. Hiya. What are you doing? Lynn, what are you doing there dressed as a duck? Come up. Let's see. This is Lynn. Now, this morning, I was looking out the seventh floor window. Can I, Can you squeegee? This is a question, Hannah. Can you squeegee while I chat to Lynn about why she's dressed as a duck? Yes, I think we can do that. They're going to squeegee. Just to be clear, this is not the show, in case you think it's very avant-garde. It's an arts festival, after all. If you want to regard that as a piece of durational experiential theatre, then do. But it is just the squeegeeing of a stage. Meanwhile, in a phrase I never thought I would need in my life, I'm going to ask Lynn why she's dressed as a duck. Tell me. I was looking out the seventh floor window earlier and I went, oh yeah, that's Lynn, she likes ducks. Is that why?
It's not only that I like ducks. We're from Stoke, the Stoke Town Tappers. And if anyone visits our wonderful city, we always greet each other as duck. So it's raining, we like the rain, we love ducks, so why not dress as a duck?
Absolutely. To be honest, the last bit of your logic isn't 100%, but if you want to dress as a duck, why shouldn't you? That's the world we live, come on, why not? And you carry it off really well.
Not everybody looks this good in a duck outfit.
To be fair, you are right.
I am.
Okay. So you were just performing. How was it? I mean, we didn't plan on doing it with the threat of slipping on a slippy stage. But how was it performing finally, getting to finally do it?
I really enjoyed it. I aren't good at the steps. Some of the girls in our groups really, really are. We've got the biggest age range of any of the groups. Our youngest member is 26. Our little Chloe, and our oldest member is 78, and she is amazing. You wouldn't think she was 78, so we're all between those age ranges.
Oh, it's so impressive, and I love seeing you perform. Ali, pop up, come and say hello. I love seeing you perform, and between you and me, don't tell the rest, but your group's my favourite, so there we go. Ali, this is Ali from Cobworth. Come, oh, so Lynn, you can stay if you like. Come under on the umbrella, let's get close.
Under the umbrella, yeah.
Come on, get close. I literally can't manage this with the cards. Now, you live on a houseboat, is that right?
I do, yes.
And how is it practicing tap on the boat?
Oh, I can't do it on the boat, it just wrecked the floor. So I have to go out and go on the pontoon.
Well, there you go, that's really good. Is it safe on the pontoon, or is there a sort of bit of jeopardy that you might slip in?
It's about as safe as this is today, so I've had a lot of practice.
Great, there you go, that's fantastic. Well, we got away with it. How was it performing?
It was wonderful, absolutely great. We, especially in front of this fantastic audience. It's brilliant, thank you.
Yeah, well done, everyone. I think we should praise yourself. Let's have a round of applause to all of you. Nice work. If you just arrived, this is Tappin In, and everyone's been learning to tap dance, and we're sharing, you know, come hell or high water. I mean, it's high-ish water. And the squeegeeing is happening. Well done. Give it up to the squeegeers. Someone's going to tell me when ready. Happening news. Lynn is literally deflating. Are you reflating yourself? How are you doing that?
It's all in the batteries, look.
She's got batteries. She is reinflating herself with batteries. This is great, isn't it? In all seriousness, who is now on Amazon covertly ordering one of these? Down here, high five. Seriously, were you? She was seriously ordering one. To be honest, if I wasn't a little tiny bit busy, I'd be like going, how much is that? Yeah. And then now we know that it's battery powered. I can feel it inflating against my leg. Again, not a phrase. Yeah, I literally can feel the wing inflating against my thigh. So it's going well, isn't it? Someone's going to tell me if we're going to move on or when we're going to move on. Do you know what I really like is that there was a lot of discussion yesterday about how much water to put in this fountain. Which it now strikes me as being a little bit of an ironic conversation we had, but because it's getting bigger by the second. So, like I say, if you've just arrived, we have all been learning to tap dance and sharing stories, sharing about what home means to us, because that's an essential part of that. So it becomes about where we're from, the different areas of the West Midlands we're from, and a celebration of that. And so were you talking about that in your groups? Because I know you're from two areas who've come together to work together. Yeah. So what discussions did you have about you know, what home means to you?
Yeah. We talked a lot about it, to be honest, Kit. We had lots of discussions, people came up with lots of different ideas. And what we came back with was home is a feeling. Home is not bricks and mortar. It's not where you live. It's not the town or the city or the house or the street or the boat. Home is a feeling.
Oh, that's fantastic. I think that's an amazing, inspiring thought, yeah. And your home is in a different place all the time, so.
Absolutely, all over the country.
Oh, that's brilliant. Are we going to attempt to keep dancing? I don't, no idea. Can anybody? We are going to do that. You've deflated. Yeah, I'm saving Singing in the Rain in case we absolutely need it. Because we might need a bit of a sort of Cliff Richard at Wimbledon sing-song moment. But yes, we are going to be singing and dancing in the rain, literally. Right, so who are we going to see? Yes, thanks a lot. Give it up for Lynn and Ali there. Yes, health and safety. Oh, God. I want to get this right. Okay. So, coming up, we have Cannock Chase. First, you're going to see Birmingham. Now, we were just chatting about home and how important the concept of home is to this project. So you're going to see a short film in which our participants, our dancers, talk about how important home is to them. Hit it.
Home, a dwelling, a place. Much more than just a shell, the base where everything begins. Somewhere to build memories, where we share both the good and the bad. Our shelters, our sanctuaries. It's Mum's chicken korma, her cheesecake with mini eggs on the top. My window watching the birds, the squirrels, watching my vegetable patch grow. Tea in my favourite mug. The smell of tomatoes grown in my father's greenhouse. Rock canes, barnet rolls, Frank, Floyd. Watching TV with my family. Singing karaoke at the top of my voice. Different music playing in every room. I know when I'm there. It's where I'm safe and secure. It's where my heart is.
Walking stumbling, the police are 61 and I've never lived anywhere else. And it's lovely to live somewhere where everybody knows you. Everyone knows your history and that continuity of knowing that I'll live here for the rest of my life. And that's comforting.
A home means support, love, and of course protection, and of course security, because I feel very secure with my family, and it makes me feel like I'm actually home with them.
We all have different experiences. Like I said, some of us have always lived in this area. We're all quite a diverse group, really, and quite different experiences.
I've loved meeting everybody else from all different walks of life, and we're here doing our tap dancing. We've got a common interest, and it's just been wonderful.
Chase, one more time, come on. Do you want to come under my umbrella? Oh, Mr. Blue Skies, the ironies keep on coming. No, oh, fantastic. Oh, before that we saw Birmingham. Amazing. Sam and Shane, where are you from Canuck Chase? Come and have a chat with me. Hi, Shane. Also, give it up for the people doing the squeegeeing. Again, can there be a more British saying in the world? Give it up for the people squeegeeing. Shane, come over. We'll find Sam, don't worry. Sam will find us. Somebody rest. Sam, come and say hello. Shane, come and stand over here with me. This is Shane, everyone.
Hello, everybody.
How was tap dancing with no tap shoes in the rain?
Just a new skill, actually.
A new skill, exactly. That's the attitude we like. Is it a skill that you thought you needed?
Nah.
No, that's the right answer, but it's the skill you've now got, and that's what life is. Hiya, Sam. How you doing, Sam?
Ah, feeling good.
Is that why you were going off there, just doing high fives with the rest of the gang?
Yes, actually.
Yeah, of course you were. I saw you. You were like, oh, we did it. It was amazing, and no one fell over and everything. It was amazing. So how was it, how did you find, because you've been practicing a long time, so how was it finally getting to do it?
It's been really good fun and very educational, and
And Tappin's really kind of cool thing to express in the way that the other people could join in and be a part of the team. I mean, it's a brilliant experience, and we enjoyed every minute of it.
Well, we've enjoyed watching it, haven't we? Isn't that amazing? So inspiring. Are you under the drips? Do you want to come in, Shane? Huddle together for warmth. Again, it's a very British moment. We are going to see Chelmsley Wood and Solihull. That's our next group. Thumbs up. Are you excited over there? That's brilliant. So and I need your help, Shane. We're going to introduce this in a special way. Now, I'm looking out there. Who remembers, like, in the golden age of Hollywood, there was the MGM logo? And does anybody remember the MGM starting thing? What was the sort of essential part of it? Lion! Exactly. It was a lion. Do you remember? And the lion roared. So we're all going to do a roar together. Now, let's just see if we can make this happen. Should we do a roar first? Let's try it. So I'm going to go 3, 2, 1, and then you all roar. And use this as an opportunity to get a little bit warm. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. 3, 2, 1. All right, now look. Camera for me. And can we turn on the special effect? Look at this. Look, David, how excited you were. Now go straight down the camera. We're all going to roar, and Shane is going to do the special roar, okay? Now this is a classic golden age of Hollywood. This is going into Chelmsley Wood, Solihull. Are you ready? How are you feeling? Sorry, I'm dripping on you, which is very, very helpful. Confident. He's feeling confident. And what else?
No anxiety in my gut.
No anxiety. That's perfect. I'm worried. Okay. We're going to do a couple more rehearsals. 3, 2, 1. No, bigger than that. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Hit it. And let's see what happens.
When you're 4'5", hip, hip. Hip, hip. Now don't you be that ickaroo. Get hip, come on, and then you follow through. You get your study food. You make up the jolly jump of the like of the gators do. Jim, jim, jump is a jumping jive. Makes you like your eggs on the Jersey side. Hip, hip. Jim, jim, jumping jive makes you a hep, hep on the Mahala side. Tibbly, bubbly, bubbly, fiddly, bumbly, goodly, giddly, bang, 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 tang, da, da. Now I'm told you about the jumping jive. Jim, jim, jump the jumping jive. You got to think this mellow jive. Yes, yes, you think it on the mellow more, boy.
Right on down to jail.
Oh, boy.
Gotta be fine.
have a ball. The Jim Jim jumping.
Give it up for Chelsea Wood, Solly Hall. Teresa, come. Teresa. Look at Teresa taking a bow. Give it up for Chelsea Wood, Solly Hall. Teresa, come and chat to us, but come down here. Are you all right? How was that?
Oh, Tappin Fantastic.
Put that on a t-shirt. Tappin Fantastic. Oh my God, how are you feeling?
Absolutely amazing. You don't realise what this moment is meaning to me. And I'm so grateful to Solihull Hall Council for allowing us to be part of this amazing Tappin In project. And Steph, we love you, Steph.
Aww. This is Steph, who's organised the whole project. Give it up for Steph. And for Lou, the partner in crime, and for all of the production team. It's an amazing team. And Birmingham 2022, everybody involved. And most importantly, they've already had a round of applause, but the people doing the squeegeeing right now. Yay! And I have just found myself saying the phrase, and I do not apologise for it, please could you squeegee my chair? This is just the world we're in right now. This is PJ from Birmingham, everybody. Give it up to my guy. Can we all get under the brolly?
Anything you can do, I can do better. Anything you can do, I can do too.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, she can, can't
okay.
she?
Okay.
She can.
PJ, you absolutely can. How are you doing? How was it finally getting to perform?
It was absolutely amazing. And I loved every single minute of it. And thank you guys for coming out.
Yeah, that's what it's about, isn't it? I love you too. We're like a proper gang. I'm always going to, anything I do from now on, I'm going to do under an umbrella because it makes you like really close. We'll have another sing-song in a bit.
Okay.
Can we do that?
We can do that.
Yeah, great. Okay, so we're having a lot of love under this umbrella, but perhaps you're all freezing, so you're like, yes, why don't you actually move on? Okay, we've only got two groups left, and then we're going to have a go at a Shim Sham, which is our grand finale, and then you can all go home and get adjacent to a hot water bottle. How does that sound? So we have got, thanks Teresa, do you want to stay under the brolly? Yes, well I introduced us. So we've got two teams left. We're going to finish with rugby, but before that we have Telford. So, Telford, very popular. So this is going to start with a short film before we see Telford dance for us. So hit it.
laugh at each other. You know, it's okay. If you're not on the beat, it doesn't matter. You know, it's, you know, we're all having fun, aren't we? You know, we're not going to end up in the West End, I don't think. We're all separately in our own locations, rehearsing and practicing our own little sequences, and we're all going to come together and be part of this quite big event. I'm quite excited. Really enjoy coming every week. You know, that first day walking through the door, wondering what on earth to expect. I look forward to Mondays now. Look forward to coming every week.
It's freeing and exciting, because, you know, when you're all getting those rhythms together, suddenly you feel like you're like part of a gang you didn't know you were part of, and that's an exciting, explosive feeling.
Everyone in that group does have special needs, but they're all so accepting, and so there's so much love and so much laughter within all of us. I want you to put yourself in our shoes and see the world the way we see the world. It might take us a bit longer to achieve, but when we get there, we get there, and when we achieve, we can achieve.
Telford, set them free. Oh my goodness. So good. Oh, I want you to reflect on the fact that all of those routines have been remade this morning to make them safe to do in the rain. Funny, now I'm crying. Oh my goodness. So like all of that has been remade and this is so beautiful to see. We saw it yesterday in 33 degree heat where everyone was tapping and now they're doing it in a completely different way in the pouring rain and it makes me so moved and so proud to see it. So come on, give a big round of applause to our dance captains, to everybody who's made this happen. I'm gonna call out all of the teams, Six Town Tappers from Stoke-on-Trent, Coventry and Tamworth, Cobworth, Birmingham, Cannock Chase, Chelmsley Wood and Solihull, Telford, and Rugby. Woo! Right, you've probably been thinking, who are the people in red? We get all the different coloured t-shirts, but who are the people in red? They are the dance captains, the pro dancers, who have guided our dancers through every stage of this process. And like I say, remade it, and then remade it, and then remade it. And so much respect to all of you. Thank you for making this happen. Yeah, impressive. And during this process, they have shared with our dancers their tap heroes who have developed this art form. And on screen now, you're gonna see some of these tap heroes. And we owe this huge debt of gratitude towards these people. So turn your attention to the screen and see these tap heroes.
I've seen further. It is by standing on the shoulders of giants.
Dance captains! Annette, come on. We've reached the end of our show. We're all gonna have a go at dancing for you as our finale because we've reached the celebration part of the show. It's all been a celebration, but we've reached the celebrating part of the show. First, I'd just like to run through with heartfelt thanks to our funders. So it is Birmingham 2022. Yes, you don't need it. You can applaud at the end, but keep it coming. Birmingham International Dance Festival, Arts Council England, Esme Fairburn, National Lottery Community Fund. Thank you to all our funders. We have reached the celebration phase of the show, everybody. So we are going to all come together and do a shim sham. I mentioned this earlier, a shim sham. It's lightening up. There's slightly less rain. Oh my God, slightly less jeopardy. Okay, because this is the moment where we're actually going to dance. Yeah, I know that means nothing to anyone else, but this has been quite a big drama in our lives. Okay, so the Shim Sham is like the national anthem of tap. It is a short routine that we have all learned, and we've all learned it, the hosting team have learned it, all the different geographical groups have all learned it, and now we are all going to attempt to do it for the first time together as a gang, all right? So let's see what happens. So here we are, for one time only. Give it up to the squeegeeers one more time. It's just so impressive. Thank you. This is what it's all about. Let's see what happens. We are going to come together. We are going to celebrate. So I'm delighted to say, but first, take it steady, be safe, but let's shim sham. Shall we do this? We all ready? Let's shim sham. Let's celebrate. Hit it.
because we're not going to keep it on risking it. Give it up for all of our dancers! Now, so we're going to be really busy. We're going to turn into a super spreader event. We love you. You are so impressive, audience. Thank you for sticking this out. This is so beautiful to see you all enjoying all of this. Thank you to all of you. Applaud yourselves, please. Thanks to the entire team. Thanks to all the funders. Thanks to everyone who made this happen. Thank you to Steph and Lou for creating this amazing project. Respect. We love you. And I mean this, no disrespect to any of the people I've just thanked, but mostly thanks to every single person who is up here dancing. The dance captains and all of the dancers. And me, and me, and Claire, and us. Thank you. Lots of love. We need to go and hug each other and probably cry a bit more. Okay, bye.